of His Holiness Pope John Paul II. He has just published a book entitled Crossing the Threshold of Hope. This is his latest, and it has become a world's bestseller. Within weeks of its publication in America, they sold 1,600,000 copies of this. I haven't been able to get the figures for Britain, but throughout the world, millions of copies of this have been sold. And in this book, His Holiness the Pope, he devotes 8 pages to Buddhism, 7 pages to Judaism, and he gives 4 for Islam. The religion which is the closest and the nearest to Christianity, the only religion other than Christianity which makes its followers to believe in Jesus, Islam. And His Holiness the Pope only has 4 pages dedicated for Islam. Buddhism, 8. Judaism, 7. Islam, 4. And he's talking about dialogue. They have sent out to the medias of the world, newspapers of the world, that they want to have a dialogue with the Islamic world. When they talk about the Islamic world, I think they have in their mind, especially the Arab Muslim world. What is this dialogue His Holiness is talking about? For the past 10, 15 years, every time I've been reading about His Holiness's movements in the different countries of the world, I read that when he went to Turkey, he made a pronouncement that we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. When he went to Nigeria, he said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. When he went to Kenya, he said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. Who is this we? That's the Roman Catholic Church. They must have a dialogue with the Muslims. And I was waiting. I was waiting for somebody from the Arab world, from the Al-Azhar, going along and having a dialogue with him. From somebody from India, Pakistan, some Alim Allama, going and having a dialogue with him. I'm waiting to read in the newspapers that so-and-so went there and they had a discussion and what they spoke. And I'm waiting, and I'm waiting, and I'm waiting, and nothing happens. Things were happening, but the world didn't know. So I wrote to His Holiness. I said, Your Holiness, you want to have a dialogue with the Muslims. The Holy Quran also tells us to have a dialogue with you. Allah tells us in the Holy Quran, Qul, say, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, O people of the book, O Jews and Christians, Ta'ala, come. Ila kalimatin sawa'in bainana wa bainakum. That we come to common terms as between us and you. Let us get onto a common platform. And the terms and conditions of getting together, Allah gives them to us. The fairest that one can imagine. You can't imagine anything fairer than that. Number one, of getting together. Number one, سَأَنْ لَا إِلَّا اللَّهِ, that we worship none but Allah. وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا, and that we associate no partners with Him. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, and that we do not take from among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, but if they turn back, they don't respond. وَقُولُوا شَهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ, tell them that we are Muslims, we are submitted of rules to the will of Allah. The Quran tells us to have a dialogue with you. And your book in the Holy Bible, your Bible, in the book of Isaiah, God says, come, let us reason together. So this is a commandment given by God in the Bible and in the Quran, and I am prepared to come and have a dialogue with you in the Vatican, in Rome, at your convenience. Time, date, to your convenience. No response. I wrote another letter. No response. I wrote another letter. Then I get a response, telling me that His Holiness is prepared to receive me in His secretariat, in private. Secretariat, in private. So I write back to him. I say, Your Holiness, you see, this dialogue is not between Ahmad Didat and the Pope. This dialogue is between Islam and Christianity. And the whole world will want to know what's going on, what are we talking? The news media of the world will want to cover it. The TV networks of the world will want to cover it. Islam and Christianity, one side 1 billion Muslims and over 1,200,000 Christians. they are having a discussion, and the whole world will want to know what are we talking. So there are 3 plane loads of young Muslims are prepared to come from South Africa, and my brother from the UK, my brother from the Middle East. All these people want to come and hear what we are going to talk. Dialogue, what dialogue we're going to have, what are we going to talk about? How big is your secretariat? So no answer. Again, please, let me know. I'm not telling you to come to South Africa. If you want to talk to me, come to South Africa, to my city of Durban. No. That's arrogance. This man is great. He is the head of 900 million Catholics. They take him as an infallible person, like God. Whatever he says is like the voice of God, the voice of Jesus Christ. His title is the Vicar of Christ. He's the Viceroy of Jesus Christ. Whatever he says is Jesus Christ putting it through him. No, as such, it's arrogance on my part to tell him, hey, you, come, talk to me. No. I'm prepared to come over. No response. How big is your secretary? No response. Then I get in the post a picture, this one here. Now I don't want to put my hands to my eyes the way he's doing here, because this camera is catching. The camera will catch me, and then someday somebody shows the film and says, look, Dida is playing hide and seek with people. Look, in Bradford he was doing that. He was doing like a monkey tricks. So I don't know. Therefore, I just show it to you. I'm sorry that all of you, you can't see it. It's too far away, but I think it will be available on tape. On the tape, I'm sure these people will be able to catch this. So I get this picture in the post, which gives me the answer to what he's doing. He's playing hide and seek with Muslims. The picture comes in the post. Akhi Jibreel wouldn't have delivered a better message to me to say, look, you're wasting your time. This guy is playing hide and seek with the Muslims. This picture. One picture is worth 10,000 words, says the Chinese. And here, I think it's worth 20,000. So I was disappointed. And I come to Britain. And in Birmingham. And Dr. Abdullah Nasif of the Rabita, he happened to be there. And some body of society invited him for lunch. And I got also blessed. They also invited me. And we happened to sit side by side. He's an old friend of mine, Dr. Abdullah Nasif of the Rabita. So he's asking me, Ahmad, he said, what happened about your debate with the Pope? It wasn't a debate. But what happened about your debate with the Pope? That's the only word they know, debate. See? I said, no, we were going to have a symposium, but however. What happened about your debate with the Pope? I said, no, that guy was playing the fools. You know, he's making a mockery of the Muslims. You know, he's playing the game with us. I knew it all along, but I didn't want to say that. But now I said, look, I'm convinced that the guy is playing a game. So Dr. Abdullah Nasif tells me, he says, he did it to me too. Look, he doesn't mention that. In those chapters I named, Buddhism, he mentions people that he had discussion with among the Buddhists by name. Judaism, on the subject chapter on Judaism, he speaks about the Jews with whom he had personal discussion. About Islam, not one word about any name, no Muslim name at all. Amazing. Man, you want to have a dialogue with the Muslims, You mean to say you never had any chat with any Muslim? In your experience, not one name. No name. As if the Muslims don't exist. However, so Dr. Abdullah Nasif tells me, he said, you see, he did it to me too. I said, what did he do? He said, you see, when I was in Egypt, his agents, the Pope's agents, they came to me and said, look, if you want to meet His Holiness, he'll be happy to receive you for a dialogue. And he said, I agree. No, Arabs are simple people. Wallah, they are simple people. We Muslims all are simple people. We are, can be easily described as simpletons. You know simpleton? You know what is simpleton? You know a ton? Ton is 2,000 pounds. Simple is simple, full of simplicity. Huh? No. Simpleton in English means a bloody fool. No, you don't know. See, the guy says, yeah, he's a simpleton. It happened. I was doing a lecture in one of my towns in Natal, Stanga, and the chairman, he happened to be a teacher at the school. He happened to be a chairman. And he's describing me to the audience. Says,